Hi, I'm Pavel, and today we're going to be talking about tmux. If you're not familiar with Unix systems, tmux might be one of the first tools you would like to learn if you're working on the remote servers. And if you're familiar with Unix, but if you don't know about tmux, I hope this video might be useful for you as well. So tmux stands for Terminal Multiplexer, and it allows you to create many different windows on the remote server and to have the full control over the jobs in these windows which you might be running. For example, if you're working from home and you would like to submit a job on the remote server, you would like first to connect to the remote server using, for example, SSH connection. Then when you submit this job on the remote server, you would be dependent on this connection. And if for some reason the connection would be lost, for example, because your computer decides to install updates and restart, or you have issues with your provider, what will happen is the job which you submitted to the remote server will also be gone. tmux allows you to create sessions, these windows on the remote server, in a way that you would be able to detach from these windows and attach as many times as you want. And then you would be able to submit the job and to close your PC and, for example, go to bed, and in the morning you can again attach to the same session where you were before and see what was happening in the terminal. There is another tool which is a bit older than tmux, and this tool is called screen. It has similar functionality, but if you have never used either tmux or screen before, I would strongly recommend you to first learn how to use tmux, because it's more modern and it has higher functionality. So let's practically explore how to set up a tmux session. If I run command ls, it will show you what I have on my home PC in the home directory. So I would run command ssh in order to connect to the remote server. And here I am. I'm right now on the remote server. This server is called server 001. Again, let's type ls. We check what we have in the home folder of the remote server. So in order to run tmux, I would type tmux, and that would create a new tmux session. In the bottom, you see this green line. This is also called status line, and in the bottom of the status line you can see the date when the and the time when the video is being recorded, and also you can see on the left bottom corner the number of the session, of the tmux session, and the number of the window we are running in. So in principle we can create multiple windows within the same session, and we can also create multiple sessions. But in order not to overcomplicate things, let's just focus first on one window and one session. tmux is just, again, created a new window, which is exactly the same window as if it would be when you just SSH to your remote machine. So for example, here I would like to run a simple command, for example, a copy command, and I would like to copy a very large file. For example, I have a file in my backups folder, and it's called my backup.zip, and I would like to copy this file here. And I know that for sure that that procedure, that job will run for quite a while because the file is quite big. So now let's have a look what happens if the internet connection is broken. How can I simulate that? I would just close the terminal. So the terminal is gone, we're not connected anymore to the server, and let's see if the job is still running if I open the terminal again, and if I attach to the same tmux session. First I need to put my password in order to be on the remote machine. You can see here I'm on the remote server, and in order to attach to my previous tmux session I need to run command tmux attach, or for short I can use just tmux a, and I will be attached back to the tmux session I was just running before. Here you can easily create as many windows as you would like, And in order to create windows, in order to detach and attach in tmux, you would have to run specific tmux commands. Any command in tmux will be starting from so-called prefix. And prefix is just a combination of keys ctrl+b. So, for example, if you would like to create a new window within the same session of tmux, you would have to run command prefix c. And prefix is ctrl+b, so that means we type first ctrl+b and then c. Not all together, ctrl+b and then c. So I create a new window by ctrl+b and then c. So here, once we have created this new window, you can see also in the bottom that this window will be number 1, just a newly created window. And let's run another job here in the new window, which could be, for example, job top. And top job just allows us to monitor the system and the processes which are running on the server. On top of that, I can create one more window, and I would do it by typing again prefix or ctrl+b and then c. Here you can see we create the window number 2. And in this window, I will run another job, and that will be the script train.sh. This is just a script which runs this funny train on the screen. So in order to switch between the windows in the same session, I would be using command ctrl+b followed by the number of the window. For example, if I would like to go back to the window where I had my copying job being run, I would need to type ctrl+b 0. And then if I would like to go to the window number 1, which was top command, I would type ctrl+b 1. And to come back to my train, it will be ctrl+b and then 2. Now, if I would like to reduce the number of my windows, and if some of my jobs are done, for example, I stop this job train.sh, and I would like to close my tmux window, I would type exit. And that would close my window number 2. And the other two windows will still be running. And if I would like to detach from tmux session without having to close the terminal, I would have to do ctrl+b and then d. D stands for detach. And here I am back on my remote server, the way how I accessed it using SSH connection. Now, in order to attach back to my session, I would type tmux a. And here we are to the tmux session where we have just two windows open. I would like to quit the top command, and then I will type exit. And here I am back to the job, to the copying job at the window 0. Okay, so what happens if I kill this job and then I tap exit? It will show me tmux a exited, and I would not be able to attach back to my session just because all the windows in this session were closed, and that tmux will point that there are no sessions existing here. These are the set of very basic commands you need to know to start working with tmux. These commands are mentioned in this slide, and I have also attached a cheat sheet with the basic tmux commands in the video description. Another important point I would like to mention here is related to the use of the same account over the multiple user on the remote server. It's not uncommon that the whole team is using the same account on the remote server, and if this is happening and many people are creating tmux sessions, please try to exit the windows in tmux and to exit the tmux sessions once you're not using it, because it would be very useful for the others not to keep track of other tmux sessions. However, if many sessions and many users have to run tmux, it's possible to create several sessions and to name them accordingly. I'll describe that in the next video. You could also find it useful to run tmux locally. This is a very common practice for many people who are doing data analysis or who are doing coding in order to keep all their windows organized, tidy, and to organize to their own standards, so that you would not need to set the same setup jobs once you open the terminal again and again. With that, I would like to finish this video, and I hope you found it useful. Please leave me a like, and I wish you happy data analysis.